Hello everyone and welcome in this video. This week I will talk about initial integration time. When a model is defined as a system of differential equations, the solver starts to solve the equations based on the initial conditions specified in the model, with the name of each ODE variable followed by underscore zero. For example, this variable size that follows a linear growth could be a tumor size and the initial condition is initial size. This 0 refers to the index of the prediction time, but it does not mean that the time corresponding to this initial condition is necessarily 0. In this video, I will show the different possibilities for the initial integration time and their impact on the model. If I want initial size to refer to the size at time 0, then I need to specify the initial integration time in the model with t underscore 0 equals 0. I could also write t0 equals 0. It is an equivalent Mlxtran keyword. Here is an example of two predictions in Mnxtran based on this tumor size model and the population parameter values here. The plot in the initial estimates tab as well as the individual fits shows the prediction starting at the time of the first record from the data for each individual, so the first dose or the first observation, whatever comes first. In this case, the first observation is at time 20 for ID1 and at time 30 for ID2. But if I draw a line on this slide to extend the prediction to time 0, I can see that the initial size of 200 is the size at time 0. This is the real time at which the solution of my ODE starts. It is possible to use any number for the initial integration time, not only 0. This number can be positive, like here, or negative, but it cannot be a parameter or a regressor. For example, here I have the predictions from the same model as previously, with an initial size of 400 at time 20. The prediction looks good, but let's see what happens if the initial size of 400 is at time 30, like here. In this case, the prediction before time 30 for ID1 is the constant initial tumor size, 400, because the ODE is not solved backward. This solution before time 30 is unrealistic, so this situation where the initial integration time is higher than the time of the first record for some individual should be avoided. Setting an initial time before the first dose can be useful to allow the system to reach steady state, as is done in the simple PK-PD example where the dose is given at time 0. PK and PD data measurements start at 0 and are displayed on these plots in green. An arbitrary initial value for the response R is given in the model, and a negative initial integration time is specified to allow the response to reach the steady state before time 0. Although here the initial steady state value could be computed analytically, this approach is useful for more complex models for which it is not feasible. It is also possible to leave the initial integration time unspecified in the Mlxtran model, like here. In this case, the initial time is the time of the first record in the data for each individual, which means that each individual can have a different initial integration time. This is the case here. The initial size of 400 corresponds to the prediction at time 20 for ID1 and at time 30 for ID2. This can be especially useful, for instance, when modeling tumor size data, such as in this example. Here, the treatment starts at time 0 for all individuals, but the initial measurement of tumor size before the treatment is at different times. The initial tumor size, called TS0, could be estimated as a parameter, but it might not be possible to describe it with a simple distribution, especially if it represents sizes of tumors that may be at different stages. Another option used here is then to read it as a regressor from the data. Finally, the very simple model of linear growth that I have chosen in order to have a clear example for this video can also be written with a closed form, like this. It is recommended because it is much faster to compute such a direct equation than to integrate an ODE. In that case, the time corresponding to initial size is explicit in the model and is the same for all individuals. With this equation, It is at time zero, but the equation could be adapted to consider a different time, and it does not have to be necessarily before all observations. That's it for this video. Have a nice week!